audible to all? Hello? Is audible to all?
Sir, voice not clear.
It is hypertension there. So, anyone have any problem with that voice? My voice is clear, all of you?
No, sir. Your voice is not clear.
Hello?
Yes, sir. The voice is not clear.
Not clear, sir.
This problem is there. It is clear. Hello? 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 Hello?
Hello? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello, is it clear, all of you?
No, sir.
Hello. Is it clear? Hello. Sanjay, Jaipur. Hello.
Sir, your voice is not clear, sir.
It is clear? Now it is clear? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Clear, sir.
Clear, na? We should start. Okay? So we are already discussed in our last classes what is actually called as manufacturing processes, and what are the what is actually basically called as a manufacturing. And from that, what are the different processes we have used in the workshop for the different jobs we can be done in the, within the workshop. Okay. So what is actually called as a manufacturing process? We already discussed that manufacturing.
Your voice is not clear, sir.
What? The voice is not clear.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Your voice.
Yes, sir. I'm just checking that. Hello. Hello, it is okay? Hello. I just changed the network. Hello, it is okay? Hello.
Yes, audible, sir.
Is okay?
Yes.
Audible, no? Okay. So, we have started that, huh? So, we already discussed that in the last class, it is actually called as a manufacturing process. What are the different processes used in the workshop for different jobs prepared within the workshop, okay? So, I not go through about that, because we are already discussed, and you can write also. Write is all these things you have to write. So you check it that how, what are the, okay. So I just again I told you that what is actually again that what is called as a manufacturing. Okay, so manufacturing is a production of work pieces having different industrial shape. What is actually basically called as a manufacturing? Hello. Is a collection of interrelated activities that is designed Then first you have to product design, then documentation. You have to prepare a documentation, then metal selection.
Your voice is not clear, sir.
Drawing and post because documentation is presented. Hello.
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 Your voice is not clear.
Hello. It is clear, all of you. Hello. It is audible to all.
A lot of noise is coming.
Hello. It is. Abhishek Chaudhary.
No, sir.
It is audible.
Sir, I think your mic is not working properly, sir.
Hello. क्या हो रहा है आप लोग आपका आवाज नहीं आ रहा है हेलो ठीक है मैं एक बार कंप्लीटली काट देता हूँ काट के आवाज न्यू ज्वाइनिंग करते हैं हेलो
ओके सर
यस सर
Hello, it is audible to all? Audible to my voice? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is audible to my voice? Hello, it is clear now?
Yes, sir. Last year.
Yes.
So, my brother?
Yes.
Gee, it is clear? Hello?
Yes, sir, it is clear. All? Okay, yes, sir.
Najamuddin, it is clear to clear my voice?
Yes, clear, sir. Clear. Yeah. Clear.
Okay. That is how we can start now. Okay. So we start the things off. Okay. So we are already. Discuss about that what is the manufacturing processes. Now we can start the from the one of the shop which will be called as a fitting shop. So bench work and the fitting shop. Ma'am, we call it particularly heavy and medium engineering. So what is that actually called as a heavy engineering? Heavy engineering basically we are called when you are manufacturing any ship, ship or you call as a so that is called as a heavy engineering. And medium engineering, basically, if you have manufacturing as a machine, different type of machine, generator, motors, turbines, so this is actually called as a medium engineering. Okay, so even today also, we use the automating machining. Basically, we are the work in the workshop, it will be used in the automating machining. But the bench work and the fitting, but it is these two part of this particular workshop is a very important role for completion of any kind of, to a desired accuracy. So that means that a handwork is very, very important for our fitting shop and the bench working shop. Okay. So majority of work of the can be finished with a good degree of accuracy, okay, throughout our machining operation. But some skill will be have given by the finish of this job by hand. Okay. So one of these particular is called as a bench work. So starting from the fitting shop, which will be work on this particular body, which will be called as a thing which is on the bench, so that is why it's called as a bench work. Okay, so finish of the job by hand on the bench, so that is called as a bench work. So actually, basically, the all the vices and all the instrument, or you have the put whatever the different jobs which will be provided. So this all the job during the working condition which will be have put in this bench, so that is why it's called as a bench work also. Okay. Now fitting shop. So what is that actually called? That fitting means that preparing matching part. When you the two part which will be have manufacturing and we have to match each other. So that is called as a matching parts to touch or join each other in a such a way that one will be turned inside to another. So that is called as a this jobs which will we have this part which will we have put inside this particular job. So this is called as a male and this is called as a female part. So that's why our main first working in the fitting, which will be have this type of wear, which will be have objective. We have a preparing as a male quality. So they are turned inside another, okay, or one will be slide upon another. So you have to put a slide to do that together, or the parts which will be hold together. So that is called as a fitting shop. Okay, that is actually basically as a fitting. So here this type of is which will be given this part which will be inside put inside this other part, okay, and actually we have is a put as a drill here. So there is a different shape which we have given here also. So this is the one part which will be have also this is called as a this two part which is inside this particular job. Okay, so this side which will be called as a male and this is called as a female. So this is actually called as a the joining between the two bodies or start inside the one body to the other. It is called as a fitting shop by preparing in a fitting shop. Now there are different fitting operation which will be have done. So that is called as a fitting. Just hold 1 minute, okay. So in fitting operation, in fitting operation work is required to use the large number of hand tools or power operated portable tools and equipment are involved in a number of operations to finish the work to a desired shape and size. So that is called as a fitting operation. What are the different fitting operations? So I just take as a pen. Okay. So that is all as a marking. So what is that actually? Marking out or layout means the process of transferring a design to a workpiece. So that is actually called as a starting point of the any kind of body which will be manufactured. So this is actually, and it's just put in the workpiece. Actually, there is a different marking conditions which will be given. So that is called as a marking. The first step in the manufacturing process. So in this particular marking operation, which will be have that marking part, we will start to the job in the workshop. Okay. Now the chipping. Chipping means the chip off of the chipping or chip off means the chip of the remove the material from the workpiece. So that is called as a chipping by the hammering or any other instrument which will be used. You can join, I think. I just so. Operation. So that is actually basically the operation to remove the material in a store. Okay, that is a, there is a, some there is a, some materials which we have not used for this particular job, so that we are removing. So that is called as a chipping off, helping the chipping instrument. Now the filling is a material removal process, fracturing, same as to the both the sawing and the grinding in effect. It is used mostly for finishing operations. So filling is basically called as a finishing operation. Process. Okay, the filling operation on a wide range of material on a finish operation. So filling process achieve work is function called as a filling operation. Okay, one of the given example I give you, that this is a sandpaper which will be have a finish the wood materials which will have, that is called as a filling operation. Now scrapping. This is a, one of the another operation which will be called as a fitting. So done in the fitting shop is a produce a more accurate finishing than obtained in the filling. So that is called as a, that is the scrapping operation which will be more finishing as compared to the filling operation for any kind of jobs. Okay. Then the another part which will be called as a grinding. The grinding is an abrasive machine used to grinding wheel as the cutting tool. So this is our grinding wheel. So this is called as a grinding wheel. We grind the surface of this particular workpiece. Okay, and here this is the grinding material. So then grinding abrasive for materials which will we have joining to each other and to form as a one of the grinding machine. Okay, or called as a grinding wheel. Okay. Now the next part is sawing. It is also, so this is called as a sawing operation. Just cut the body which will be have according to your our requirement shapes. Okay, it should be done slowly and standing position. Okay, in a appropriate for this operation. So cutting takes place in a forward stroke of hacksaw. So it is cutting is always in the forward stroke and the backward stroke is always ideal condition. So that is called as a sawing operation. Okay, now another operation is called as a drilling operation. Is a cutting process that use a drill bit to cut a hole in a circular cross section in a solid. So there this is which we have put in a hole. So I just show you again that. So this is called as a drilling operation. So we just put it in a hole in this particular job. So this is called as a drilling operation. Okay, here there is a putting in the job. So and there is a so many drilling bits is there. There are some different shape of drilling bits is used to cut the hole of this particular any kind of jobs. Okay, now reaming. The reamer is a type of rotary cutting tools to use as a metal working. What is that used actually? Reamer is actually basically to enlarge the size of the hole previously which will be done in the drilling operation. So that means if you put it in a hole and we just be enlarge the size and the hole size which will be enlarged, that means the diameter which will be increased, internal diameter which will be increased of this particular workpiece. So that is called as a reaming operation. Okay, so here which we have reaming tools, and this particular reaming tools, so this is called as a
few planes, and this is called as a sang part. Okay. So in this particular case, this is the rim, rimming tool which will be have some taper, the cutting part which will be have some taper, which will be called as a helix angle. So there is some angle which will be put it in this gear. So this is called as a helix. Okay. Now here this is a state fluid hand rimmer. So this is called as a this part which will be have a state one. I guess it was a state. Okay. This part which will be straight one. But here which will be have some angle which will be cutting in the teeth. Okay, so this is the difference between the teeth. So this teeth which will be some angle, and this angle which will be called as a helix angle. But here, that teeth which will be straight. Okay, now this is also called as a taper rammer. So this is the taper means this is the rammer which will be have this side which will be more diameter, and this side is less diameter. So that is the diameter which will be reduced from here to here. So this is called as a taper. So taper rammer. Okay, now it is another part which will be combination of spiral rimmer with a pilot drill. So this is the rimmer as well as drill, both of that. So you have to take the drill first, then you have to put enlarge the hole. So that is called as the rimming also. Okay. And here is another cell rimmer. This is all. This is just put it here and just drill rimming the job. Okay. And this is this part which will be called as a adjustable in a insert rimmer. So this is this rimming cutting tool which will be have just adjusted according to your requirement. So there is a called as a rimming tool. Okay. Now next part is called as a tapping. So this is called as a taper. Okay. It is a process of cutting as a thread inside a hole so that the cap screw or bolt can be threaded into the hole. So that means this is the tapering which will be used to thread cutting inside the bolt. So that is called as a tapering process. Okay. Just we have take as a bolt or any screw and just put the inside the thread. Okay, by this capping method. So here we have three different types of cappers. So I just show you that this one first. So this is called as a threaded length, and this is called as a shank length. Same thing here also. This is called as a thread part length, and this part which will be have shank length. Okay, and this is called as the overall length. Okay, now here we have three different types of capping tappers we are used. Okay, this is called as a taper tap. So there is a tap. This is tap which will be called. This is 8 to 10 tap taper thread for according to the dimension. Okay, and this is called intermediate tap. So that is called as a. This is also called as a plug tap. 3 to 5 taper thread in the this particular tap. And this is called as a bottoming tap. So this is actually 1 to 1.5 thread. So that is this is the first part which will be have put. And then after again we have put in the second part which will be have taken. This is an intermediate tap, and this is the last as a bottoming tap. Okay, so this is called as a tapping operation. Now the next part is called as a dyeing operation. So dyeing operation is an operation by use of different shape of die for the external thread cutting. So the tapping which will be basically we use for the internal thread cutting. So this part which will be basically the internal thread cutting of any kind of screws, cap screws, then cap screw, and basically we have put in inside in the that is called as a bolt, okay, or any some cylinder which will be have provided, which will be have in a taper machine. And but when this is the dyeing which will be operation is called as a the external thread if you cut. When you cut in an external thread, then it is called as a dyeing operation. Mostly called the thread which will be cut in the bolt in the outside thread. So that is this is the two die which will be taking in the to put in a external thread cutting operation. So that is called as an adjustable round split die. So adjustable round split die actually basically this is the screw and just loose and the tighten according to that and according to our working conditions. And this die which will be have the shape which will be coming out. Okay, and this is called as a plain round split die. This is the die which will be have fixed. Okay, and just put these two die which will be put in this particular distor. Okay, and this put it here, and just to tighten that just this like of that, this doing like this type of shape which will be given it, and here just show you this particular that. This is the die which will be put here, and just move the clockwise and anti-clockwise, and this thread which will be cutting in the outside diameter, outside of this particular bolt or any kind of material. Okay, so that is called as a dyeing operation. Okay. Now we come to the next part. Fittings of instrument or tools. So what are the different tools we used in the fittings of? So first, which will be called as a holding tool.
So we have basically, when you do any kind of jobs, so you first hold the jobs in this particular vices. Okay, so just hold it and then you do the work. Okay, so that is actually called as a vice. The vice is the most common tools for holding work. Okay, so therefore vice are most suitable and widely used tool for gripping different jobs in position during the various operations carried out in a fitting shop. So that is the vice is basically the holding tools. Just hold the jobs or work piece and you just do the work of this particular work piece. Okay, so that is actually basically as called as a vice. There is so many vices which are used. So I just show you that. This is called as a parallel job bench vice, then leg vice. Next one is called as a hand vice. Then fourth one is called as a pipe vice, then pin vice, then toolmaker vice. So we have a total six number of vices, different vices according to the working we have used in the workshop. Okay. So that means that in the workshop, there is total six number of vices is used. Whole of this workshop. It is maybe in a fitting shop, it is maybe in a you called as a welding shop, or you called as a bench smithy, that is called as a metal shop, that is blacksmithy shop, or you have put in the carpentry shop or machining shop, whatever the shops which will be used in the workshop, which will be there is a sixth number of vices which will be used. Okay, so first vices is called as a parallel job bench vice. So this parallel job bench vice is basically the mostly usable vice, and sometimes it's called as a parallel job vice. Okay, these vices are available in different trade size, and the selection of suitable size will be depends upon the maximum size of the work. Okay, and the vice actually basically the same size of the vice, which is basically the size of the jaws. Okay, in fixing it is fitted bench. It is held with the help of bolt passing through the flank of the bench. Okay, and the bolt are tightened by means of nuts and vices is we hold on the bench. Okay, so I just go for one by one. What is that? Now parallel job bench vice. So this is actually basically in our this diagram which will show the parallel job bench vice. What is that actually? Sorry, it is the most commonly used vice. Sometimes it's called as a parallel job vice. It is essentially consist of cast steel body. So this is a whole body which will be have the cast steel body. Okay. A movable jaw. So this is there is a two jaws. This jaw which will be called as a movable jaw. This is this whole part which will be have the movable jaw part. Okay. And so this I just show you this one. So this part which will be whole which will be have movable jaw inside this fixed jaw, or it's called as a stationary jaw. So that means this jaws which will be move. When you tighten this, the move to side this side, and it is loose, it is coming this side. So this is the moving from here to here, inside this particular stationary jaw. Okay, so in a movable jaw, a fixed jaw, both made of cast steel. This is the movable jaw, both are made of cast steel and threaded screw. So this part is called as a handle. So handle, and this is called as a square threaded screw and a nut. So this part which will be called as a nut. So the nut is provided inside Hello. So, hello. Is audible to us? Hello.
Yes, sir. Audible.
Hello.
Yes. Audible.
Hello. Okay. So that is I can continue. Some interrupter, someone is called me back. Okay, so what is that? Actually, this is called as a handle. Okay, and this is a square threaded screw and a nut. So these all are made of mild steel. Okay, and a simple cast steel plate. Skin is not visible. I just saw it.
No, sir.
Okay, I just see this. Now it is it visible to my skin? Is it visible to my skin? Yes. Is it visible? Is it visible to
yes,
all?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Hello. Is it visible to all? Hello.
Yes, sir, visible.
Hello.
Yes, visible, sir.
Hello. Is it visible to all?
Visible, sir.
Yes, visible.
Hello.
So visible, sir.
Okay. So hello. Fayaz? Hello, Fayaz? Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Hello. Is visible to visible my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I can continue, na? Okay. Hello, I can continue.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What is happening? There is any problem, is that? Hello. Hello. Ansari, Paj. Hello.
Yes, it's audible, sir.
Hello, Pajuddin. Hello.
Yes, sir. Speak.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Audible.
Yes, sir. Audible.
Okay, that is okay. That is okay.
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 So, so this is a separate cast. So that is actually basically this is the handle. Then the square threaded screw and the nut. So this one is called as a nut. All are made of mild steel. Okay, and a separate cast steel plate known as a jaw plates. So this is called as a jaw plates. Okay, so jaw plates with a teeth are fixed to the jaws by means of set screw. So this is called as a jaw plates. I just show you again that. This is a very important part of that. So this is called as a jaw plate. This part. This side and this side. Okay, so this is basically made of the cast steel. Okay, it's called as a jaw plates, and jaw plates which will be looking this way, this way, this just this way, just cutting this fashion, ruling of that. Okay, so jaw plates with teeth. So this is called as the teeth of this particular. This is the teeth which will be given. Just show you that this is the teeth which will be have. Just in this way, I just show you that this side. Just put in the teeth on this person. Okay. I just take a color, change the color. So this person, the teeth which will be formed. So that is actually jaws. Okay. So these two jaws which will be have fixed on the stationary and the sliding jaw. Okay. So these teeth are fixed to the jaws by means of set screw. So here which will be put in the screw. In these two places we put in the screw. So here. Just two screws which will be put in this particular point. So, okay. So this, they can be replaced when normal. So that is when these jaws which will be have break, then you have to replace it. Okay. The movement of the vice is caused by the screw which is passes through the nut. fixed under the movable jaw. So this is this particular jaws, movable jaw, which will be fixed on this particular nuts, okay, nut and bolt here, okay, and this particular which will be moved from the inside the stationary jaw, okay. The screw is provided with a collar. So this is part actually be collar. This part. So this is collar. The collar of this particular screw. This is the collar. Okay. The screw is provided with a collar inside to prevent it from the coming out and handled at the outer end. So the handle which will be provided outer end, and this is the prevention which will be provided in the lead screw. This is the prevention which will be provided. So that means the lead screw which will be not coming back. Outside of that, okay, and here which will be prevented, and this is handle which will move it clockwise or anti-clockwise, okay, to prevent it from the coming out and handle at the outer end. The size of the vise is known by the width of its jaw. So this is very important part. Show you that this is very very important part for the classification of vises. So this is the width of the jaws. So this is called as the width of the jaws. This part. The width of the jaws suitable for common work varies from 80 to 140 millimeter. So that particular job, so any kind of jobs which will be have the common width which will be given for 80 to 140 millimeter. Okay. Now come to the next leg vise. So this is also another vise which will be used. This vise is basically used in the blacksmith shop. Blacksmith shop which will be basically the where the we have PPRA. Nut, bolt. So this is actually basically we are used as a blacksmith shop where we will prepare as a nut bolt from the any kind of workpiece job. So it will be circular or cylindrical body and just put it in the blacksmith chamber and just hit it, and which will be hammering in this particular within the on the anvil and put it just hold it in this particular point. So that is actually basically we use as a blacksmith shop in this particular vise. Okay, this is also suitable for having hammering, chipping, or cutting in the fitters work. So the fittings of it is also used for this particular type of leg vise. Okay, the vise is secured to the top of the bench. So this particular vise which will be fixed on this particular point here. So this is the one of the bench, and this particular bench which will be have trap on this particular. So just fixed on this particular point. So here which will be fixed it, and in this particular L shape which will be have plate, which will be have this particular plate which will be fixed on the bench also. Okay, so this vise which will be fastened to the bench leg with a serpent and its end feet with the holes on the floor, and this end part. So this is called as a leg. See this leg which will be put in the surface of this particular any floor, which will be put inside the floor. Okay, so this is the holding two holding points. This is the one of the holding points is particular leg vise, and here which will be have put it here. So in this particular same cases here, this is called as a movable jaw and this is fixed jaw. And just the handle which will be have moving when it is a clockwise or anti-clockwise move, when it is a move in a anti-clockwise sense, then it is a opening, and it is a clockwise sense is according to that. Okay, so when it is a move, so just it is moving in this fashion, just put it here, because in this particular point it is fixed here, in this particular point it is fixed. So here it will be moving this fashion, not moving the whole body in the last vise. Which will be in this last vise, the whole body which will move in the towards this side. Okay. But here, this is a fixed. In this particular point, is a fixed, so it is moving in this fashion. Just move in a certain distance, and then this is the close. Okay. So that is called as basically called as a leg vise. Now this is the another vise which will be called as a hand vise. So hand here, which is put it in hand. Very small work which will be done in this particular, and to grip here, this particular point which will be grip it and grip this particular. Suppose we have put in a any kind of a small nut and just filing it. Suppose we just put in a nut and we just file it, just nut in this particular point and tighten in and hold it in your hand, and just one hand you hold it and another hand you will be filing. So this is called as a hand vise. Now the vise is used for the grip screw, rivet, keys, are very very small part of which will be product which will be have done by this which will be holding a points. Okay, and other similar objects which will be too small. This is made of various shapes and size. The length varies from 125 to 150 mm jaws. So this is the length which will be have the jaws length which will be have 125 to 50 mm and width from 40 to 45 mm. The width basically is a 40 to 45, a 44 mm. So that is actually called as a hand vise. Okay. Now we come to the next one. Called as a pipe vise. Now, this vise is used for holding round section metal, tubes, pipes, etc. So that is here, we just put it in this particular point. So just, this is a one type of vise which will be have here. In this particular 3 points, which will be put in the jaws and just hold, put in the any kind of, suppose we have a put in the pipes in this particular point. Just circular pipe, we put it here, okay. And tighten by this particular handle and the screw. Just move in this particular handle and just this three vise which will be tightened this particular body. Okay, so it is maybe cylindrical or any shape which will be have. Okay. So this is basically the circular pipe. So it is maybe pipes or it is maybe tubes or it is about circular cylinder, solid circular cylinder, whatever are you called as a bolt, you have nut which will be put in this inside this particular vise and just tighten it. Okay. So this is a another kind of vise which will be used for the workshop. Okay. So it is called as a nut, and this is the upper jaw and this is the lower jaw. This is this is called as the upper jaw, and this is fixed on this particular points, and the lower jaw which will be fixed in here, and just grip in this particular points. Okay. So this is called as a pipe vise, a pin vise. This is also very small type of vise which will be have just a small type of work which will be have done on this particular to hold it actually. When you done any small type of work, just suppose filing or cutting any kind of small work, suppose we call it as a pin or work, and just hold it here. You just hold it one hand, and other side which will be have put it in the pins or any other things, and just whatever you the process which will be given. So it is maybe cutting or it is maybe filing or whatever the process which will be have. So this vise is used for holding round metals of a small diameter such as wires and the pins. Okay. So this is the three jaws which we have, and just put it in a workpiece in this particular point and in by the chuck. Okay, there are so many pin vices we are used for holding the small work. Okay, so for it is maybe used for the fitting shop or it is maybe used. This vice actually basically used for the homework, home any kind of in the home. So that is actually used on not only in the fittings of, it is used in everywhere of this particular vise. Okay, so there is called as a pin vise. This is the two regular vise which will be used. Okay, just put it here and just tighten this particular point and then just hold it in there. This is called as a master pin vise. So most of the cases which will be used in this particular vise. And this is the double-ended vise. So this is double-ended vise means both of the side, just hold it in the middle of that. Just hold it in the middle of that. If you have put it in here also, and it put it in here also. And this both on the side you can cut or any job which we have done. Okay. So this is called as a pin vise with double ended. And another is called as a adjustable pin vise. This is called this vise which will have adjustable according to your requirement. Okay. So that is called as a pin vise. Now another type of vise which will be called as a toolmaker vise. Okay. So in the toolmaker vise is also some particularly used for the dealing and the dealing operation or a very small operation which will have done. Okay, this is this vise which is basically sometimes used for the woodworking operation, or you have holding the this vise which will be holding the for doing the joining operation. Or suppose we have to put in the holding on this particular any kind of body, I just hold it here and just put it in the hold also. That means holding also this particular cases. So, which is required for filling and drilling also. Okay, this vise is made of a mild steel. Just put it in the nut and bolt in this particular 2-4 points. Same things which we have, that is a sliding jaw, this is a fixed jaw. So, this is a fixed jaw which we have as a one single unit. And the sliding jaw which will be fixed on this particular screw, and this is called as the handle. Okay, just handle which will move, the jaws which will move out. Okay. So this will be used in our workshop, any kind of workshop we are using the for the holding of any kind of jobs. Now the first we have come to the measuring tools. Now, starting from the measuring tool. The measuring tools are used to measure any kind of components with respect to the dimension. Okay. So, without this tool, it is not easy to measure the accurate value of the given component. So, the job which will be have first measure it. So, this is the measuring tool which will be used. There are so many measuring tools which will be used in the workshop. This first, there are seven total types of measuring tools are normally used in the workshop. That is called as the first is called as a steel rule and measuring tape, then surface plate, then third one is called as a caliper, then fourth one is called as a divider, next one is called as a tri-square, then sixth number is called as a vernier height gauge, and seventh number is a micrometer. Okay, so there is a total seventh number of measuring tools we are used in the any kind. It is maybe workshop which will be called as a students purposes use, or you call as a production purposes use. Okay. So first we are starting from the steel rule or the measuring tape. The steel rule is one of the most used for taking linear measurement of blanks and articles. So this is the called as a steel rule. Basically, normal scale which will be used in the drawing. So when a drawing purposes or any other purposes which will be have when it is work in a workshop, then it is called as a steel rule. So that is the basic difference between this in a drawing shop and the workshop. The drawing shop, it is basically we are used as called as a steel scale, and we use in a workshop that is called as a steel rule. That is this is the basic difference, nothing but that. The other difference, other things are same. The dark measuring things, one side is meter or centimeter, another side is called as the inches, foot and inches will be used in this particular steel rule. Okay, so there is a different size of the steel rules used in the workshop, because this size is also used in our drawing purposes. Okay, the size is called to have the length which will be have 150 millimeter, then 300 millimeter, then 500, and then and the last which will be have not last, because there is a another also nowadays there is so many big scales which will be are big steel rules also used in the picture. So there is actually now we have 1000 millimeter long. The width of the length up to the 500 millimeter. So the if you have the length up to the 500 meter, the width maybe is 18 to 20, 22 millimeter, and the thickness is 0.4 to 0.6 millimeter. So the thickness of this particular steel rule is equal to 0.4 to 0.6, and the width which will be have 18 to 22 millimeter. Okay. If the ruler length is more than 500 millimeter, so that means if the length is more than greater than 500 millimeter, up to suppose we are considering as 1000, so 500 more than 500 to 1000 millimeter, the width is used actually normally with the width. Width which will be has 42 millimeter, and the thickness is 0.8 to 1 millimeter. Okay, and another measuring tool we are used also in a, basically the construction purposes. This type of measuring tools are used, so that is called as a measuring tape. Okay, and basically this is very easy to carry, so that's why this whole tape which will be put in the inside of this particular cap. Okay, so here and just take as a you just put in your pocket, so this is very easy to carrying. So that's why the most of the structural this type of tape which will be used, not as compared to the steel rule. Okay, and here which will be put in a one of the metal to fix in a rivet, because if you not put it here, just goes in the inside of that, and here in this particular cases, and it is also used for the measuring the vertical condition. That is why we just put it in a 90 degree of that. Just measuring the 90 degree of it. Just it is a holding for the measuring of this particular tape. Okay, so this is called a steel rule and the measuring tape. Another is called as a surface plate. The surface plate is used for the testing the flatness of the workpiece itself, and it is also used for the measuring outward. So suppose we have a yes. So this work piece. Suppose this is one of the work piece. Okay. suppose this is the our one of the plates workpiece. This is our one of the plate workpiece. I just check it that these faces. I just first finish these faces and check it that these two faces which will have flat or not. Just put it here. Just put in this particular points and check it that these two face, this upper face or bottom face, which will be whatever this was, or these two faces, whatever the four total six faces which will be have flat or not. Just check it in this particular surface plate. Okay, there are so many surface plate, and this surface plate which will be basically made of the gray cast iron. Okay, and from that there are so many shapes which will be have the height from the from this height from the base of the surface plate. So this is basically, sorry, from that, from here to here. This is called as a 800 mm. The working height being from, which will be called as a 800 mm. Okay. And there are different shapes which will be have in the workshop in surface plate, which will be have 1.5 to 5 meters, then 1.5 to 3 meters, 2 meters and 2 into 4 meters. So this is basically for the industrial purposes we are used for this surface plate. 2 into 2 meters and 2 into 4 meters. But these two are basically we are used for in our the student purposes surface plates. Okay. So this is also of the our measuring tools. Now that is the caliper. Now there is a caliper. What is that actually called? The caliper is basically used to transfer and compare a dimension from one object to another, or form a part of a scale where the measurement cannot be done directly. So that is called as a caliper. So the caliper is basically that we have to done calculate the dimension of this any kind of body. Okay, but the accurate dimension of this particular any kind of body. So that is actually basically we are as a one of the instrument which will be used to measure the dimension of the body. If it is measured in a, inside the diameter, or it is maybe outside diameter, or it is taking as a length, or any kind of groups which will be have measured the groups of this particular any kind of body which will be have used for this particular caliper. There are total 7 types of caliper we are used in this particular cases. So it is called as a outside caliper, inside caliper, then spring caliper, old leg caliper, then vernier caliper, then dial caliper, and then another which is called as a digital caliper. So there is a total 7 types of calipers we are used in the workshop. Okay, first we come to outside caliper. So that is actually called as a outside caliper. Okay. So in the outside caliper, the caliper is a 2-leg. So this is called as a leg. So this 2-part which will be called as a leg. Okay. Which will be have bent inside. So these 2 legs which will be bent inside of that. Here is a bent and here also bent. So these 2 legs which will be bent inside of that outside caliper. Okay. It is used for the measuring or comparing thickness, diameter, and other outside dimension. Okay. So this basically used for this dimension which will be have outside of the body. I just show you that one of the, suppose this is a cylinder of that particular. Okay. So this is also called as a. So just measuring it, I just put it here. I just put it here. I just put it here in this way. So that is called as a grid. The legs which will have bent inside. So this is the leg which will have bent inside. I just put in the diameter and just take it as a scale here. I just put it as a scale. Suppose this is a scale. Just show you that. So this is that we have, and this is the here which we have. I just take in the dimension. What is the length or what is the diameter of this particular cylinder? So this this outside caliper which will be measure the outside diameter or outside dimension of this any kind for the outside caliper. Okay. Now put in the inside caliper. So inside caliper is actually the same as that outside caliper, but it is bent, but the legs which will be straight, the outside caliper, the that. So it is a, the legs which will be have some curvature which will be given. Okay, but in the inside caliper, it can be inside caliper, the legs are straight. Okay, but the legs end which will be bent outside. These two legs end which will be bent in the outside of the body. Okay, so here we are measuring the whole dimension, whole diameter, then distance between the shoulders or any other surfaces which will be have for the inside cases. So inside diameter, dimension which will be measured by the inside caliper. So this is the same things which will have just so this is also have same cylinder. Okay, so this is the hollow cylinder. Suppose this is the thickness. This is very important. This is a hollow cylinder. That means we have put in the inside diameter of the wall. Okay, so that is the. This is the outside diameter, so this is outside diameter, and this is inside diameter. Okay, so we have to measure the inside dimension of this particular inside. Yes. Here in this way, okay. And which will be measured by this scale. We use the scale. Here I just put it here. This is the scale. There is a scale. And put it in this particular point. We just put it here. And this put it here. Just measuring whatever the dimension or any dimension inside the dimension of this body. Meter or it is maybe any dimension which will be have whatever the dimension which will be calculated by the inside of the body. So that is we use for the inside caliper. Okay. Now come to the next part. Spring caliper. So the spring caliper is same as the inside and okay, the both are the same, but it is a spring connection connected by the two spring. Okay, in these two legs. So here is the same thing that. A normal outside caliper which will be have, there is no any spring which will be given, just point, just riveting or holding it, or just maybe it is a riveting, and just put it here, a screw, and just move in this. But here which will be put it here in the spring is here. So that is called as a spring connection outside caliper. Okay, so the size which will basically from, I just told you, same things which will be have inside caliper also, and just hold it in the same condition. I just show you here also, here directly show it, just put it here, just tightening it and just check it there, whatever dimension which we have, outside dimension. Just in this particular cases, we have a caliper which will be have moved in this fashion, just move in this way, or it is moving the outside of that, outside or inside, which will be by the use of this particular nut, which will be have put in the spring here. Okay. This is called as a leaf spring, which will be have. Okay, spring here. Now here, same things which will be have. This is called as a outside caliper. Just here, just put it any body, which will put it here. Okay. This is inside of that particular. Just which will be have, same things which will be have. Just controlled by this particular nut. And here which will be have it, so it is moved inside and outside. So this is maybe move in this direction, or it is maybe moved in the inside and outside. So outside and the inside. Okay. So this is now I just show you that. So this is a pivot. This is where we are already discussed as a leg, and this is called as a knob. Okay. Now here is a leaf spring is there, and this is called as a nut. Now, another kind of caliper which will be called as a odd leg caliper. Okay. This type of caliper is sometimes called as a unthodite caliper. Okay. So it is It is not, it is one pointed leg. So this is this type of caliper, which is basically this one side will be pointed leg, like a divider, and the other leg is able to bend. So this side which will be bent, and this side which will be have pointed. Okay. This caliper is extremely used for sometimes for scribing lines parallel to the edge on the workpiece. I just show you that. Suppose this is our workpiece. Suppose I just put it here. I just want to, this is a, suppose this is a one of the line. Okay, I just draw a one parallel line here. What is happening? Just put it here. This part, which will put in this particular point here. Here, just put it here. And this called as a divider. This is a pointed divider. Just put it in this particular point and just move from here to here. Just in this fashion, just I just take it here. Just I just show you that this is the pointed and it is bent. In this fashion, okay. Just here which will be have fixed. So just take it and just move from this is the parallel line we have to draw. So this is the edge line. So this particular workpiece is this is the edge line, and we have to draw the parallel lines of this particular. So that is there we are used for this particular odd leg caliper. This is also called hermaphrodite caliper. Okay. Another is called as a vernier caliper. So this is very very important part we are used for the measuring tools. This is vernier caliper. Most of the cases this is a single instrument you are use all the dimensions. It is maybe dimension in the inside diameter, outside dimension, outside diameter, or any other. Suppose we have to measure the grooves of that particular body, or whatever that is how much depth which will be have given this particular any kind of body. Whatever you have measure, which will be used for this particular single instrument is called as a vernier caliper. The vernier caliper is also is a device used to measure the dimension of an object. Okay, the vernier scale maybe include the metric measure on the lower part of the scale. So this is the metric dimension, and this is called as the inch dimension. An inch measure on the upper cases, and vice versa means that some countries which will be used for the inches, then they are used for this particular lower part which will be used as the inches, and the upper part which will be used as a meter measurement. Okay, so that is according to your requirement which will be used for the vernier. So okay. Now, the vernier caliper commonly used for the industry provided a precision of 0.01 millimeter. So, that is the least count which will be have 0.01. Okay, I think anyone can tell me that what is called as a least count? What is called as a least count? Anyone can tell me that? Have you know that what is called as a least count? How to calculate the least count? So the least count, I told you that least count, basically least count LC is equal to pitch by total number of division. Okay. So here pitch means the division between the two points. So, okay. So that is actually just told you that. I just show you, I just read is a very difficult to calculate, but I just show you that. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is a 1 inch for each and every. Okay. So now from that 1 inch, which will be have one point, which will be called as a 0.5. So that is actually called as a 0.5 inch. 0.5. Why? Total number of divisions. Suppose this is a here. I don't know how it is not showing. So suppose this is a 50 division. So that is a 50 division. Suppose we are assuming the total division will be 50. So that is called as a least count which will be coming out. If it is coming out, so 0.01. So that is, this is a 5 division. It is a, put as an inch. Suppose here is a, and bottom part which will be have millimeter division. So upper part which will be inch division. This is a millimeter division. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't know. I think it's not so here properly. So suppose this is the process which we have. Okay. So it is maybe, suppose this is not, this is 0.1. So this is called can as a 100 division. So this is called as a millimeter. Millimeter. So this is actually coming out. So least count is basically which will be called as a number of pitch, total number of pitch by the, sorry, pitch by the total number of divisions. Okay. Now this the vernier calipers can measure the internal dimension. Actually, basically this vernier which we have used for the internal dimension. This this is for these two jaws which will be have used for the internal dimension. So that is which will be provided in the upper jaws. Okay. And external dimension which will be have put in this lower jaws. So this is the put it here. So this is a internal dime body. This is just hold it here. Internal dimension. Dimension of the body, and here it will be put in the external dimension of the body. Okay, just external dimension of the body, and in many cases the depth actually by the use of the prop. So this is called as a prop. Okay, that is attached to the movable head. So this particular prop which will be attached on this particular head, which will be backside of that. Okay, and slide along the center of the body. So it is sliding on this particular center of the body in the backside, so not seen in the front of that body. Okay, this probe is slender and it can be check the depth of the groups and in any kind of body which will be have just put it in a inside this particular depth. Suppose I just put it here, just put it in the depth and just check it how much depth of this particular. Okay, just put it here and so this is one of the instrument which will be used for this purposes called as a vernier caliper. Now the dial caliper. So this is also another same kind of caliper is called as a dial caliper. It's the same as the vernier caliper, but here which will be provided as a dial. So this is the difference between the general or conventional normal vernier caliper and the dial caliper. Dial which will be provided in these particular points and just directly measured by the dial. So that is called as a dial caliper. Okay. So just directly which will be measured in this particular when you dimension which will be provided here or whatever that is, here which will be provided or here which will be provided, and just according to that the dial which will be moved and you just directly measure on the particular dials. Okay, so that is called as a dial caliper. Another type of caliper which will be called as a digital caliper. So just whatever the dimension which will be, so this just check directly in this digital formation here. So that is called as a electronics digital display. So just display of this particular point and just check it that what is the actual dimension of this body. So you have same things which will be have. So inside the dimension, then outside dimension, or you have to group check the groups of the depth of this particular any body, which will be directly measured by this digital calipers. Okay. So this is, there are so many here now which will be have here digital caliper. Now divide there. So this is just check it here. We just stop. I just show you that. This is the calipers which are being used. Okay, so we can stop here. We can continue in the next class for the different types of another devices which will be used. Hello, Fayaz.
Yes, sir.
We can you can continue. You saw your workshop or any workshop, the fitting shops and the different instrument which will be used in the fitting shop or any.
I
like.
Okay, sir.
Like.
Okay. Sir. Sanjay, पूरा shop को दिखा दो, उसका हम tools लेकर के जाते हैं, सब tools.
वो ही रखा हुआ, मैं बोलने में टाइम लगेगा. ठीक है. ओके सर.
हाँ थैंक यू. यू कैन स्टार्ट. यू कैन स्टार्ट.
ओके. हाँ यहीं से शुरू करो. अरे बंद है इधर. तुम इधर जब तक देखो मशीन सब जब तक देखा हम इधर से खोल रहे.
हेलो स्टूडेंट. हेलो
स्टूडेंट गिव रिस्पांस.
हाँ हेलो
Okay.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
This is a machine shop.
Machine
shop. Machine shop. All our machine shops. One by one, introduced to name. First name of the machine in this shop. Lathe machine. Lathe machine. This is a lathe machine.
No, still, are you seeing?
Hello?
Still, are you seeing lathe machine?
Yes, sir.
Response? Okay, okay. This is lathe machine. Name of the machine tool. This is another lathe machine to hold the job. Hold the job inside chuck. Ready for job starting. Another same to same lathe machine. This is a lathe machine. Also this lathe machine. This is a three jaw chuck lathe machine. Three jaw chuck. All are 1, 2, 3, 4. Four machine are same. This is a four jaw lathe chuck, also lathe machine, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four jaw chuck, independent self-centering system. This is a lathe machine. This machine is power saw. Power saw machine, different type of job cut here to hold inside the vice. Power saw machine, metal cutting process used. Another machine, you can see this machine. Drilling machine. Name of the pillar type drilling machine available here in this mechanical workshop, Kansas Engineering College. Other machine is shaper machine. Shaper machine. Next is also shaper machine. Down feed handle, tool post, vice, ram, different type of part in this machine. During the working period, describe one by one name of the machine and name of the parts, this machine. Hello. Response. Please response. The second, third is milling machine.
हेलो ठाकुर जी.
हाँ सर.
पहले तो आप लेथ दिखाइए, उसके बाद तो मिलिंग में जाएंगे ना.
लेथ हो गया सर.
लेथ हो गया.
हाँ लेथ हो गया. केवल मैं नाम बोल रहा हूँ, क्लासिफिकेशन स्पेसिफिकेशन और उसका साइज जो है बाद में बोलेंगे, पहले ऐसे ओवरऑल मैं इंट्रोड्यूस कर रहा हूँ.
ठीक है. ठीक.
हाँ
भाई सर,
मिलिंग मशीन.
हाँ बोलिए बोलिए.
हम बोल रहे थे सर कि अभी जस्ट नाम बता देता हूँ, जब जॉब स्टार्ट करूंगा लेथ सेपर में तब उसके बारे में डिटेल्स बताऊंगा.
तभी प्रोडक्ट का नाम थोड़ा सा बता दीजिए, ये पार्ट्स का, सॉरी किचन, उसका जो जितना पार्ट्स होता है उसका थोड़ा सा बताइए, तो उसको ओवरव्यू हो जाएगा क्या क्या पार्ट्स होता है. ऐसे ब्लैंकली देखने से क्या पता चलेगा कि क्या देख रहे हैं.
ओके सर.
थोड़ा सा मतलब ज्यादा एलबोरेटली नहीं है, बट यू कैन टच इट एटलीस्ट. ओके
ओके. ठीक. पार्ट्स का नंबर था,
दिस इज ए मिलिंग मशीन, नेम ऑफ दिस पार्ट, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पार्ट, दिस इज फर्स्ट आर्बर फिक्स ऑन द कटिंग टूल मटेरियल, नेम ऑफ द कटिंग टूल मटेरियल, मल्टीपल पॉइंट कटिंग टूल, दिस इज टेबल वाइस वाइस फिक्स ऑन द टी स्लॉट टेबल, दिस इज वन टी स्लॉट फिक्स ऑन द वाइस लीवर, दिस इज एंगेज ऑफ गियर, डिफरेंट वेरी ऑफ द मोशन, ओके नेक्स्ट चैनल सर डिस्क्राइब दिस नेम,
नो सी स्टूडेंट्स यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इट, दिस इज मिलिंग मशीन, मिलिंग मशीन मे बी स्पेसिफाइड बाय द वर्किंग सर्फेस ऑफ द टेबल, ओके बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग स्पेसिफिकेशन सी हाउ विल यू स्पेसिफाई मिलिंग मशीन, स्पेसिफिकेशन मीन्स इफ यू विल बाय अ पेन, you will buy shoes or etc. Suppose you are buying a pen, then you have to tell about the pen, means a what type of ink and what type of what is the company and what is the diameter of the ball. Okay, just like you have to specify the machine. See, milling machine may be specified by the working surface of the table. This is table. Working surface table means the width of the table. See, and this is the length of the table.
And working surface. I can enter. I can interrupt you. Anyone can told me that this check it the vice. Vice. What is that called vice? This type. What is this type of vice? Anyone can tell me? I just told you. Anyone can tell me? Anyone okay. can tell me? What is this type of vice? I already told you that.
Tell me. What is strength given, sir?
Anyone can tell me?
Strength given, sir? Mm-hmm. Sir, is this?
Sir, parallel jaw bench vice.
No. This is
bench vice.
Okay. This is bench vice, but what is that actually exact name? Is that? What is that called? I just told you that.
Okay.
This is called as a tool maker vice. Okay. Okay. Then continue.
Okay, sir. See, to parallel every vice has parallel jaws. So there are called parallel vice. Okay. See, this vice also have parallel jaws. As you are seeing, the vice is. Movable jaw is moving. I am opening it. Okay, with a hand. Are you seeing the jaw is moving, students? Given, sir, students.
So video is not clear, sir.
Video clear.
Okay, you can. Okay, continue. Are. Continue. Well, sir. Continue.
Okay. See, students. This is. Tool maker vice. Okay, we are using tool maker vice on the machine. Okay, so this is milling machine vice. See, this vice is moving. See how you specify vice, sir. I have already told you. Can you tell me how you specify vice, students? No, see, I am telling you again. Vice may be specified by the width of the jaws. Means, see, these are two jaws. Width means this is width, okay? Width of the jaw. It may be 8 inch, 6 inch, 3 inch, okay? And maximum opening between two jaws. See, this is the opening. See, I am opening it. See, there, I am opening it. Are you seeing the well jaw is moving? This jaw is moving. And now see, I am closing it. This is maximum opening. Okay, now The maximum of this vice is 10 inch. 10 inch तक हम इसको मैक्सिमम खोल सकते हैं और 10 इंच जॉब हम होल्ड कर सकते हैं इस वाइस में. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, तो वाइस को हम लोग स्पेसिफाई करते हैं मैक्सिमम विड्थ ऑफ द जॉब्स एंड मैक्सिमम ओपनिंग बिटवीन टू जॉब्स. ओके, तो ये वाइस है. सी आई एम शोइंग यू द पार्ट्स. सी ऑन द टॉप, दिस इज ऑवर हैंगिंग आर्म. क्रिस्टनेस, दिस इज ओवर हैंगिंग आर्म. दिस होल पार्ट इज ओवर हैंगिंग आर्म. And this part which is hanging is called arbor support. This is arbor support. See, this is arbor. Arbor is long part, okay, which is fitted in spindle. Okay. Arbor holds the cutter. This is cutter. This is cutting tool. In the milling machine, we are using multiple cutting tools. Okay, students, what type of tool we are using in milling machine? Give answer.
Multiple cutting.
Yes, multiple cutting point means the tools which has more than two cutting points. Okay. So see the many cutting point. So this is called multi point cutting tool. The specific name of this cutter is side milling cutter. Okay, this is cutter or cutting tool. And this one is arbor. Now see, cutter is fitted in the arbor. And this is column, which is vertical position. This is column. And now see, I have already told you about it. This is vice. Okay, and this one is table. This is saddle. Okay, and this one is knee. This is knee and this one is base. Okay, where is foundation bolt is here. This is base. Okay, so ye iska parts hai. And this is column and knee tap milling machine. And column and knee tap milling machine, this is universal milling machine. Okay, milling machine different types ka hota hai. To abhi hum jyada details mein nahi jayenge. हम सिर्फ यहाँ दिखा देते तुमको. सी दिस इज मिलिंग कटर टू द स्पेसिफिक नाम ऑफ दिस कटर इज साइड मिलिंग कटर एंड नाउ सी दिस इज मिलिंग कटर और मल्टी पॉइंट कटिंग टूल. दिस इज गियर कटर. वो साइड कटर था स्पेसिफिक और ये गियर कटर है जिससे हम लोग गियर गाड़ी का जो गियर होता है उसी को कट करते हैं. ऑलरेडी ये गियर है जैसे ये गियर इसमें प्रिपेयर किया हुआ है. ठीक है, मुझे तुम लोग ये देखे होगे गियर गाड़ी का हर एक पार्ट में रहता है गियर बॉक्स में. ओके, तो ये रहा मिलिंग मशीन का. तो हम लोगों के पास जो है दो टाइप का मिलिंग मशीन है. यूनिवर्सल मिलिंग मशीन, ये जो है यूनिवर्सल मिलिंग मशीन है. नाउ सी, बिकॉज वी कैन गिव फोर फीट यहाँ पे एक ग्रेजुएशन है. ठीक है, जिससे हम लोग ये टेबल को इनक्लाइंड रोटेट कर सकते हैं या इनक्लाइंड ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म कर सकते हैं. तो ये प्लेन यूनिवर्सल मिलिंग मशीन है और ये जो है ये हम लोगों का जो देख रहा है ये उससे भी हैवी ड्यूटी है लेकिन ये प्लेन मिलिंग मशीन है. ओके, और ये सेमी ऑटोमेटिक है. तो सर बोल रहे थे कि लेद मशीन, दिस इज लेद मशीन. दिस इज लेद मशीन. Lathe machine is a machine tool that removes the metal from the workpiece and give it a wide shape and size. Before starting this machine, I have telling you about the operation of milling machine. Milling machine jo hum log operation karte hain, wo hai gear cutting, T-slot cutting, sprocket cutting. ठीक है, इसके वो सब operation करते हैं हम लोग. T-slot cutting, gear cutting और ratchet, sprocket cutting. वे कटिंग, ये ऑपरेशन हम लोग मिलिंग मशीन में करते हैं. और ये है लेद मशीन. तो लेद मशीन में जो हम लोग ऑपरेशन करते हैं वो है टर्निंग, ड्रिलिंग, फेसिंग, बोरिंग, टैपर टर्निंग, थ्रेड कटिंग, नर्लिंग, ग्रूव कटिंग, स्प्रिंग वाइंडिंग. इसमें हम बहुत सारा काम कर सकते हैं. ये इसमें हम लोग गियर भी कर सकते हैं लेकिन उसमें अटैचमेंट लगाया जाता है, एक अलग से अटैचमेंट लगाया जाता है. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, तो आज हम शॉर्टली बोल रहे हैं कि मिलिंग मशीन का स्पेसिफिकेशन सी हाउ विल यू स्पेसिफाई मिलिंग मशीन सॉरी लेद मशीन में भी स्पेसिफाई बाय द लेंथ ऑफ द बेड सी दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ लेद दिस इज कॉल्ड बेड लेद बेड ये इसका लेंथ से हम लोग स्पेसिफाई करते हैं यहाँ से लेकर यहाँ तक का इसका लेंथ रहता है ठीक है बेड का लेंथ और मैक्सिमम हाइट बिटवीन सेंटर नेक्स्ट इज मैक्सिमम हाइट बिटवीन सेंटर ये सेंटर है इस सेंटर से लेग बेड से जो मैक्सिमम हाइट है वो हम लोग स्पेसिफाई करते हैं और मैक्सिमम डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू सेंटर एक सेंटर इसका यहाँ पे है और दूसरा सेंटर इसका स्पिंडल पे होता है तो इससे भी स्पेसिफाई कर सकते हैं मैक्सिमम डिस्टेंस बिटवीन सेंटर मैक्सिमम बार डायमीटर दूसरा जो मैक्सिमम जो स्पेसिफिकेशन है मैक्सिमम बार डायमीटर ये जो देख रहे हैं ये एक होल है इस होल में मैक्सिमम डायमीटर का जो बार हम लोग पास थ्रू करते हैं डिस्ट्रक्टिंग स्पेंडल से तो ये है मैक्सिमम बार डायमीटर मैक्सिमम स्विंग डायमीटर ओवर बेड ये जो मशीन है हम लोग मैक्सिमम कितना डायमीटर का जॉब को होल्ड कर सकते हैं जो बेड में बगैर टच किए हुए रोटेट हो दैट इज कॉल्ड मैक्सिमम स्विंग डायमीटर ओवर बेड और लास्ट है मैक्सिमम स्विंग डायमीटर ओवर कैरेज मैक्सिमम डायमीटर का जॉब जो हम इसमें होल्ड कर सकते हैं वो सेडल से बगैर टच किए रोटेट हो दैट इज कॉल्ड मैक्सिमम स्विंग डायमीटर ओवर बेड सॉरी कैरेज ओके तो ये रहा लेद मशीन का स्पेसिफिकेशन मैं अब स्पेसिफिक बोल रहा हूँ स्पेसिफिकेशन इसका ठीक है लेंथ ऑफ द बेड ओके सेपर लेद मशीन मे बी स्पेसिफाइड बाय द लेंथ ऑफ द बेड हेड ऑफ सेंटर मेजर फ्रॉम लेद बेड मैक्सिमम डिस्टेंस बिटवीन सेंटर्स मैक्सिमम बार डायमीटर मैक्सिमम स्विंग डायमीटर ओवर बेड एंड मिनिमम स्विंग डायमीटर ओवर कैरेज ये रहा लेद मशीन का स्पेसिफिकेशन अब हम आते हैं इनके पार्ट्स पर दिस इज द पार्ट दिस इज कॉल्ड हेड स्टॉक इन दिस स्टॉक देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्लच लीवर एंड गियर सिचुएटेड इन द हॉर्स ऑफ द हेड स्टॉक ठीक है ये हेड स्टॉक है इस हेड स्टॉक के अंदर में ये गियर है ये पुली है इसके अंदर स्पिंडल है और ठीक इसके अंदर में है जो टम्बलर गियर है लीवर है तो इस पार्ट का नाम हम लोग बोलते हैं हेड स्टॉक ठीक हम ऑलरेडी बोल चुके हैं ये पार्ट का नाम ये बेड है लेद बेड इसमें दो गाइडवे है एक इनर गाइडवे है और एक आउटर गाइडवे है तो यहाँ देखो इनर गाइडवे में जो पार्ट है मैं दूसरा नाम बता रहा हूँ इसको टेल स्टॉक कहते हैं ये है हेड स्टॉक और ये टेल स्टॉक इस टेल स्टॉक को देखो ये जो है इनर गाइडवे में है यानी ये इनर गाइडवे में स्लाइड करता है टेल स्टॉक और इस पार्ट को हम लोग बोलते हैं कैरेज ये टोटल होल पार्ट जो है ये कैरेज है ये है आउटर गाइडवे में मूव करता है देखो आउटर गाइडवे में मूव कर रहा ठीक है देखो मूव कर रहा तो लेफ्ट बेड का आउटर गाइडवे में कैरेज मूव करता है उसके बाद नेक्स्ट जो पार्ट है वो है लीड स्क्रू ये स्क्रू है लंबा स्क्रू जिसको बोला जाता है लेड स्क्रू और लास्ट जो है जहाँ पे फाउंडेशन किया हुआ है वो है लेग या बेस ठीक है दो लेग है एक इधर और एक इधर है ये है लेग तो ये रहा लेग का बेसिक पार्ट्स डिजिटल पार्ट्स था ये अब हम लोग अगर देखें तो सर तुम लोगों को दिखा रहे थे चाक चाक इज एक्सेसरीज और अटैचमेंट ऑफ द लेद ठीक है जैसे कि ये जो देख रहे हो ये चाक है इसको हम लेद इसको चाक बोलते हैं ठीक है तो डिफरेंट टाइप्स का चाक होता है थ्री जो चाक होता है फोर जो चाक होता है यानी ये जॉज जो है ये जबड़ा जो है तीन एक में होता है एक में चार होता है ठीक है इसके अलावा जो होता है होता है ड्रिल चाक होता है मैग्नेटिक चाक होता है ये डिफरेंट टाइप्स का चाक होता है तो ये लेद से रिलेटेड नहीं है बल्कि ये अटैचमेंट है ना ये पार्ट्स ही है ये अटैचमेंट है लेद का देख रहे हैं ना स्टूडेंट्स ये होल्डिंग डिवाइस है थ्री जो यूनिवर्सल चार ठीक है तो ठीक इसी तरह और भी डिफरेंट एक्सेसरीज है इसका जैसे ये देखो, ये है फ्लोरिस्ट, सॉरी ये है स्टेडी रेस्ट, ये भी बाहर से ही स्टेडी रेस्ट है। जब लेंदी जॉब को लोग होल्ड करते हैं तो इससे सब देते हैं। और एक ये फॉलोअर रेस्ट, ये फॉलोअर रेस्ट है, देखो ये वाला, ये जो रेस्ट है इसको हम लोग कैरेज के साथ फिट करते हैं, उसके बाद जो है जॉब को सपोर्ट दे टूल के सामने में। इसके अलावा जो है फेस प्लेट है, ये भी लेथ का एक्सेसरीज है, ये देखो ये फेस प्लेट है, ये भी लेथ एक्सेसरीज है। तो ये रहा एक्सेसरीज, इसके अलावा भी और एक्सेसरीज है जिसे लेथ पेपर टर्निंग अटैचमेंट, ठीक है, वो अभी यहाँ पे उसको होल्ड किया हुआ दूसरे मशीन में। अब यहाँ पर हम दिखाते हैं, ये रहा लेग मशीन का डिटेल्स। अब लेग मशीन ऑलरेडी मैं बोल चुका हूँ कि कौन कौन सा ऑपरेशन किया जाता है। स्टूडेंट्स शीला, कौन सा ऑपरेशन किया जाता है लेग मशीन में, जब बोलो सर, नेम द डिफरेंट ऑपरेशन विच कैन परफॉर्म द लेग मशीन। शीला स्टूडेंट गिव रिस्पॉन्स, नेम द ऑपरेशन विच कैन बी परफॉर्म इन लेग मशीन। स्टूडेंट्स क्यों रिस्पॉन्स नहीं दे रहे तुम लोग? स्टूडेंट्स क्या बात है, कोई नहीं बोल रहा है? ये देखो ये शेपर मशीन है, स्टूडेंट्स सी दिस इज शेपर मशीन। शेपर मशीन इज अ रिसिप्रोकेटिंग मशीन टूल व्हिच इंटेंडली प्रोवाइड अ फ्लैट सरफेस, इट मे बी हॉरिजॉन्टल, वर्टिकल और इंक्लाइन। ओके, तो ये भी एक मशीन टूल्स है शेपर। शेपर मशीन का डिफरेंट जो पार्ट्स है वो ये पार्ट्स देखो, ये है रैम बोलते हैं इसको, आरएम रैम। इसमें ये टूल हेड है, ये क्लैपर बॉक्स है। ठीक इस तरह मिलिंग मशीन में के कॉलम था, इसमें भी कॉलम है, ये पार्ट को कॉलम बोलते हैं, जो बॉडी है पूरा वर्टिकल है। नाउ सी देयर इज आल्सो अ वाइस, स्टूडेंट देख सकते हैं ये वाइस है, इसमें एक जॉब पीस ऑलरेडी होल्ड किया हुआ है, ठीक है। ठीक जो वाइस है वो टेबल में होल्ड किया हुआ है, ये देखो ये टेबल है, इस पार्ट को टेबल बोलते हैं, और जस्ट इसके सामने एक पार्ट है इसको टेबल सपोर्ट बोलते हैं। और ये है क्रॉस रेल, ये पार्ट को हम लोग क्रॉस रेल बोलते हैं, जिससे हम लोग वर्टिकल और हॉरिजॉन्टल फीड देते हैं। ये है पॉल मैकेनिज्म, ऑटोमेटिक में कटिंग करने के लिए यूज होता है। तो ये रहा शेपर का बेसिक पार्ट्स। ओके सर, इसमें जो है लीनियर मोशन का कन्वर्ट होता है, सॉरी रिसिप्रोकेटिंग मोमेंट जो है वो कन्वर्ट होता है लीनियर मोशन। संजय सर इधर आइए,
हाँ बोलिए।
लाइन दे दी, देखिए स्टूडेंट्स ये जो है ये हम लोगों का जो है मूव कर रहा है, जो मूव कर रहा है उस पार्ट का नाम है रैम। ओके, मूव कर रहा है उस पार्ट का नाम है रैम। तो ये हमारा जो है रोटरी मोशन जो है कन्वर्ट हो लीनियर मोशन में। इसको हम लोग रिसिप्रोकेटिंग मोमेंट भी बोलते हैं. ओके तो ये कैसे कन्वर्ट हो रहा है देखो. ये जो है हमारा नीचे देखो एक मोटर है. ये मोटर है, ये मोटर पावर ट्रांसमिट कर रहा है यहाँ पुली को. वो पुली जो है पावर ट्रांसमिट कर रहा है यहाँ पे. ये देखो ट्रांसमिट कर रहा है जो पावर, वो पावर आ रहा है यहाँ. ठीक है, ये वाला पुली में. तो ये पुली जो है इसके साथ एक गियर है, छोटा ऐसा गियर अंदर. मतलब मैं अंदर का पास पुल को देखा था. कैसे हमारा रोटेशन जो है कैसे कन्वर्ट हो रहा है लीनियर मोशन में. ये देखिए पूरा पार्ट से सेपर का, और अब मैं अंदर का पास दिखा रहा हूँ. ये
देखो घुमा रहा है
मैकेनिज्म.
हेलो.
हाँ संजय सर स्टार्ट कीजिए.
हाँ हेलो.
हाँ सर बोलिए. हाँ बोलो भाई सर बोलिए.
हाँ संजय क्या बोलना है.
हाँ
क्या दिखाएंगे संजय सर.
संजय सर फिटिंग का दिखाएंगे.
ओके हाँ ठीक है ठीक ठीक.
संजय सर फिटिंग स्टार्ट कीजिए.
हाँ ठीक है एक मिनट. वेट 2 मिनट्स. हेलो.
हाँ
हेलो स्टूडेंट. नाउ सी फिटिंग शॉप. दिस इज फिटिंग शॉप. This is fitting table. Fitting table fix on the holding device. Name of vice. Fitting vice. Fitting vice. This is jaw. This is movable part. This is fixed part. Fixed part. This is handle. To move the open and close the vice. Vice. This is fitting shop. Fitting table. This is carpentry shop. Carpentry table. Fix. Carpentry vice. Carpentry vice without jaw. Different type of job performed here. Cross halving, T halving joint, different type of joining. You can see this video. Joint and different type of tool here. Used in carpentry shop during the working period. This is a cutting saw material, wooden saw.
क्रॉस कॉट, रिप कॉट, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सॉ यूज इन कारपेंटर शॉप. दिस इज जैक प्लेनर, प्लेनिंग सरफेस टू यूज टू प्लेन सरफेस. दिस इज ए चीजेल, कारपेंट्री चीजेल, विवेल एज चीजेल. टू टाइप ऑफ चीजेल यूज कॉमनली, वन विवेल, अनदर this is a file, rest cut file, wood surface on the metal. Next of each foundry shop. Foundry shop. This is a sand. Composition of sand. Different type of tool used in foundry shop for prepare pattern making. Making a pattern, basically wood working. These are different type of pattern. Pattern, different type of composition of sand, silica sand, bentonite, coal dust available here, and green sand. The different type of instrument. This is molding box. These are molding box. Used for carpentry shop and foundry shop. Next shop is welding shop. Welding shop. Different type of job perform here in the welding shop. Three type of machine available here. One is AC current type arc welding. This is a transformer. Arc process transformer.
Hello, Sanjay sir.
And two poles connected earthing table. One is positive, another is negative. AC transformer. This is electrode holder to connect the transformer. One pole is electrode holder, another pole is clamp table. This is a earthing table. Earthing table. According to welding, different type of instrument is used. Tongs. This is tongs holding device. Chipping hammer, eye production. For eye production, huge hand seal and apron. This is apron and gloves, huge to forehand production. Gloves. Uses. Another welding is MIG welding. This is a MIG welding setup. One cylinder, CO2 cylinder. Open the valve, name of the part valve. This is a heater, flow meter and double stage regulator to attach air. This is a wire feeder. Automatically a wire feeding during the welding. Inside connect the motor. This is a trigger. Another third welding is two type of cylinder used. One is O2. One is O2. Another is C2H2. One is oxygen. O2 is oxygen. And C2H2 is acetylene. Oxyacetylene welding process. This is called oxyacetylene welding. This is valve and double stage regulator connect here. Hose pipe is color blue for oxygen, blue or black for oxygen, red color. Red color is red, otherwise maroon. Is for acetylene. This is a DA cylinder. Dissolved acetylene. Two type of hose pipe, red and black, to connect the welding torch. This is a welding torch. Welding torch. One is red, this is red is C2H2, acetylene gas, another black is
sir, what class for 3 PM?
Okay. Faisal sir.
You can stop here.
Maji sir?
You can stop here. Now you take the attendance. You take the attendance.
Sir, in logo class hai. Abhi left kar jaye sab.
Nahi, pehle attendance.
Sir, attendance. Maji sir?
Attendance sir, Google form milega ya? Nahi, likh lu main naam inka.
Chat box.
Ab log all of you give the attendance, write your name and roll number in the chat box. Also write your name and roll number in the chat box.
Chat box?
हाँ बोल दिया हूँ आप लोग
नेम डिपार्टमेंट एंड रोल राइट इन योर चैट बॉक्स
आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड
फॉर अटेंडेंस
ओके वी कैन स्टॉप हियर वी कैन कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास ओके ऑल ऑफ यू गिव योर अटेंडेंस इन द रोल एंड नेम एंड रोल नंबर इन योर चैट बॉक्स ओके थैंक यू वेरी मच वी कैन कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास